Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're well. Today's video is gonna be really chill, easy for me to do. Just gonna do another Q&A. If you watched my most recent one, I said I was gonna answer half of the questions on this channel and the other half on my non-ASMR channel, but because I'm going to LA in a week, I wanted to film a bunch of videos over the next couple of days and get them ready to so that I don't miss any uploads while I'm away, because I won't be able to film whilst I'm there, just because I'd have to bring way too much equipment. So yeah, I do have mostly roleplays planned to film, but hopefully you don't mind if I do a more kind of easy one that doesn't really require any planning or take up too much brain energy. Role plays I could find kind of tiring because you are really thinking. I mean, I feel like that makes me sound stupid, but you know, this I can just be myself and not be acting or anything. So yeah, that's the plan for this video. I'm just gonna answer the rest of the questions. I will also be filming non-ASMR videos in LA, so if you do want to see that, you can subscribe to that channel, which is linked below. I'm gonna be doing, I have planned a what I'm packing video, obviously vlogging every single day, outfits of the week. I think those are the three main ones, but vlogging, probably do a video every single day. So lots of videos on that channel if you're interested, and also follow me on Instagram, because I'll be posting a lot and also uploading to my Instagram story like constantly basically while I'm away. And yeah, anyways, let's jump into the questions. I'm just gonna answer the other half, and I might go check the post and see if anyone was a little late to the party, and I can answer those too. So number one, from Skylar Thomas, what are your top three favorite clothing pieces you own? Love you too. Thanks for the question. It's a really good question and really hard to answer. So I think I might break this up. Okay, let's see. For winter, the one thing that I wore like every single day almost, well not every day but a lot, was my like patent high-waisted pants, which are from IMGEA. I'll insert a picture of them, and I just found that they went with everything. They were really warm because of the material, so not something you would want to wear even in the springtime, but it was really nice in the winter to keep me warm. I also wore my IMGEA like black fluffy pixie jacket basically every day too. It was a lifesaver, and I thought it just was cool, but also really comfy. And then the other thing that I loved for winter was this, like, cropped long sleeve sweater, with kind of like poofy sleeves and ruching around the arm from Reformation. I have it in cream, which is what I wore most of the time. And then when I went to Miami last month, I also bought it in black because I wore it like all the time. And so those are my favorite, three favorite winter clothing pieces, I think. lot harder because I love summer gloves. Would definitely be some dress from Reformation. Maybe my new one that's like purple with floral all over it that I got also when I was in Miami last month, actually. Photo inserted. Just easy, girly, pretty, but really comfy, which is why I love dresses. And then what else? I really like top from Reformation that's like pinstripe, square neckline, and like ruching all the way around the body. I'll insert a photo again, but I've only worn it a few times so far. Summer's just kind of started, but I love that shirt. I think it's, again, something I'd actually be able to wear year round, and I just think it's classy and cool and cute, like everything you could want to be in a top. So I really like that. And what else? I feel like I want to look in my closet to see. What's something I always want to wear? My last one is this shirt from Realization Bar. It's this navy blue with little white stars, and it ties up, and it's like a kind of silky feeling material. Again, I've worn that in the winter too, but it's just so cute and comfy and cool, and I definitely like that. I wish I left my closet doors open so I could look in it. I think we'll go with those three, but that is like one of the hardest questions on the planet, but very good. Okay, then Caitlin, Miss Malwood asked, do you believe in Jesus? When is the last time you ate meat, and do you think you'll have kids in the future? Good questions. Okay, so do I believe in Jesus? I'm gonna say no. I do believe in a kind of higher power, or like a god, kind of like a mother nature figure is what I kind of see, but I don't really believe in the whole Jesus kind of religion and the way that religion, but I know there's more religions, but that like belief that that's how the world kind of formed and humanity formed, if that makes sense. I'm not like anti at all. In fact, I really like learning about religion. My boyfriend is quite religious, and it's interesting to learn about because it isn't something that I really learned about. Like, I stopped going to church when I was like 5 or something like that. So I'm not like against it. I don't think people are wrong. It's just not something I personally believe, if that makes sense. When was the last time you ate meat? I don't even know. Like, I can't even tell you the last time or like what it was. I think the last time I ate meat would have been like around grade 10, because I went vegetarian. Or no, I think end of grade 9, so I was what, 13? Yeah, because I would have turned 14. 13 or 14, and I went pescatarian, which is basically, if you don't know, you're basically vegetarian, except you still eat like fish and seafood and stuff, because I really liked, and the only thing I really liked was like crab cakes, and we would get like these frozen ones from the PC brand. I thought they were really good, because I was like all into being healthy at that time. It's when I just learned about going to the gym, and I had my parents help me get nutrition and stuff, so I'd always have that with like veggies. I was around 15, I would say. I was in England, and we went to Butlins. I don't remember which one, but it's like a resort for kids mostly. But my family just always wanted to, I don't know. I love like kid things. Like I can't wait to have kids for that reason, so I can just be a kid again and do all the kid stuff. But yeah, we were in Butlins, and there was this like spa thing on the resort, I guess, that had those little tiny little fish in fish tanks, and you could put your feet in and they would like eat the dead skin, and it was like a pedicure but cute and fun. And now looking back, I don't think I would ever do that again, because like I don't know how the fish are treated and stuff like that, but at the time I wasn't there yet in the brain. So yeah, I got that done. I loved it. It was ticklish and it was cute, and that's when I really started to love fish so much more, if that makes sense. Like I just like could watch their mouths when they would eat, and I was just like, you are so freaking cute. And fish, by the way, are like top four of my favorite animals. I think I got cats, dogs, pigeons, fish, elephants, something like that. But yeah, and actually I was the cutest thing in the world, and it would tickle, and I was like, I cannot eat you, you are too cute. So that's when I completely stopped eating meat. So that would have been, I was like 15, because I would have turned 16 that October, so I was 15 and a bit, I guess. So when within that period I ate fish, or I don't know, because I did eat mostly vegetarian. It was mostly like giving up meat wasn't that hard for me, because I wasn't huge into meat. I mean, I did like chicken with like veggies when I was trying to be healthy, but looking back, I don't miss that in the slightest. So yeah, that was basically when I stopped eating meat, and then, you know, I went vegan like later, obviously, but so somewhere in that time frame was the last time I ever ate meat. And then you also asked, and do you think you'll have kids in the future? So I guess I kind of answered that. Yes, I do, or at least I hope that I will have kids. I have like a little bit of criteria for if I would have kids. Like I want to be financially stable, and like very financially stable, because I don't want to like have to sacrifice living a nice life for children, if that makes sense. Like I want to still be able to go on vacation or buy clothes. Like obviously nothing insane, but I don't want to have to worry about money, and I know the kids do make that difficult, so I do want to be in a position where I can really truly afford kids. I also want to be in a relationship with someone that I love and view as a partner, you know, someone I can trust to have kids with, someone I can rely on and know that they're gonna be a good team player. And also still get along with each other and still love each other despite stressful situations that might arise from raising children. But assuming I achieve those goals, then I do want kids. Right now I kind of want four, but I know that's a lot. Definitely two or four, but I think four, to be honest. Yeah. Phoebe Coltart. Did you see a difference in your weight since going vegan? By the way, I love you, sis. Love you too, Phoebe. And I guess so. Before I went vegan, if you're kind of like new, definitely when I was younger, really struggled with my weight. Oh, I definitely had an eating disorder, and just really struggled to view my body in a positive light. To be fair, I was like 12, 13, so that's when girls, or at least when I and like my friends all kind of hit puberty and our bodies were changing and we were growing hips and things. And I remember, because I had grew hips, like my hips are massive now, but at the time they were bigger than my friends, and I would always be like, I don't want hips, I want like straight up and down. And now looking back, I'm like, I wish my hips were bigger. But yeah, so I definitely struggled. I tried not eating. I went through the whole bulimia situation. And so I found being vegan helped my relationship with food, in the sense that I learned to view it as like fuel and as like nutritious and something to keep me alive. And I also, I'm not gonna say I noticed a difference in terms of the numbers on a scale, because due to my kind of disordered way, my weight would fluctuate like 15 pounds. Sometimes I'd be 120, sometimes 140. Like it would really go. But now I find I can stay at like a good 130, 128, like that kind of range, with relative ease. Like obviously it's easy to like overeat, but vegan food, especially if it's more whole food diet, which I stick to most of the time because I just love it, makes it really easy to stay at a moderate healthy weight. Like I just don't really have to worry about it so much now. Definitely if I go through a phase where I'm buying a lot of junk food, then I'll be like, whoa, okay, need to chill. But like my biggest craving is always just like banana ice cream. Literally healthy, so definitely I would say so, because you just eat vegetables and healthier things when you're vegan, because you know more about it. Or I'm not sure how to explain it, but basically I think to answer your question, I would say yes. I never find myself being like, holy crap, I've gained weight. It's more like, I can do with maybe trying to eat a little bit healthier, and then it's like fine, if that makes sense. I definitely did notice a difference in my mental state, by the way, though. Okay, especially as years have gone on as well, but definitely I felt more positive and healthy and happy, which is amazing. And other things obviously contributed, but I would say food was definitely a factor. Okay, Scarlett Katie asked, what is your favorite movie? And also, what advice would you give to someone wanting to start a vegan lifestyle? Love you so much. So you can see things are all kind of related to food, because my other channel is more vegan-y focused, so that's why I had intended to answer them on that channel. So sorry if you were all annoyed, but you don't have to watch this, right? If you don't believe in veganism, maybe go watch something else right now. But okay, so what is my favorite movie? I know in my other video I said I was loving Orange County, and I'm still loving that. I made my boyfriend watch that with me again last week. I like remember funny moments from it all the time and just laugh. So that's definitely up there. Other favorites include Moana, Zootopia. I loved Inside Out at the time, but I'm not so sure how much I love it now, but it's definitely up there. There's probably more, but I definitely prefer kind of movies, if I'm honest. I love animation. I watched The Incredibles the other night, and I hadn't seen that since it came out when I was like 5, or when did it come out? I think I was maybe 7, because I think it came out in 2003. And I remember I saw it like a birthday party, because back at that age, that was like one of the things that you would do for birthday parties, was go to the movies. But anyways, and I don't remember really liking it at the time, but I watched it last week. Dye your hair any unnatural color, what would it be and why? Yeah, well, first of all, I don't think I would, because I'm a baby. But I guess maybe I would try to go back to like white, bleached, grandma kind of blonde. But I did that one time and my hair like hated me for it and all like broke off, so probably wouldn't actually. spray like a few pieces in and around, like highlights, like a pinky color or blue, probably more blue. Like, did you guys ever watch that movie from like the Disney Channel, Aquamarine? She had like blonde hair with blue streaks. I'd be mad down for that. But that's probably the most cool hair I could ever go for. Tia Ashlyn asked, what is your favorite brand to support? Very good question. So, for beauty and makeup, I love supporting any brand that uses natural products and is vegan and cruelty-free. My favorite, I guess, out of those would maybe be Pacifica. I just think they always have really good things. I love their perfume, especially the vanilla and coconut ones. So good. So I'd say those, that brand. I'm trying to think what I use all the time. For clothing wise, my favorite brand to support is without a doubt the Reformation. It's all made in the United States. Ethically, all the material is like sourced, like reusable, like they use reusable like fabric that was old or when it gone in the garbage, they use that, or like and they're, you always get reports on like how much water you saved, like they're basically just really sustainable and good for the environment, and I really really believe in what they stand for. So even though it's more expensive, I won't say I'm happy to pay because it's so much money, but pieces are beautiful and they're good for the environment and the like economy, like local economy, and like no sweatshops, so like no one was harmed in the making. So I'm happy to support that brand. Another brand that I love supporting is Matt and Nat. They're like a vegan bag, mostly bag, like basically I think I love them, and I don't have that many bags. Their backpacks, especially if you need a new backpack, they're so good. So I love supporting Matt and Nat because, like I said, they're vegan and they allow me to have like cute bags that are actually good quality and vegan. And they also, though, by the way, do shoes. And there was, I thought, one other category. I've had a pair of shoes from them before too, which are really cute. But yeah, so I like supporting them as well. Christina Simas. I don't know, sorry girl. Three words to describe you and your boyfriend's relationship. So I think Christina understands how much I freaking love him, so that's why she's asking this. Okay, let me see. Maybe like chill, although it might not be the right word, just kind of like relaxed, like trusting or something like that. Like, we're both just like really similar in terms of our energy and our mannerisms. Like, we never get in fights, and whenever we have a disagreement, we just kind of like talk it out. And I might cry because I cry about everything, but like, we really just kind of, we don't fight and yell and explode. That kind of person, and he isn't either. And I don't like being in relationships with people who are very fiery because I can't deal well with that. So I like that me and him are able to just really talk and otherwise be chill. And the other reason why I said chill too is because like we don't have to go out and do crazy amazing things. Like we love just chilling, watching movies, going to the pub, like, you know, just hanging out. Like, also do things, but I like that we don't have to. I would say maybe our relationship is also nerdy because we both are book obsessed and like talk about books a lot. It's definitely like one of the main things we talk about, like not the only thing obviously, I would say probably on a daily basis we talk about books. So, like, you know, kind of nerdy in that sense. And then, like, okay, I have two more. So, like, loving or something along that line. I know, like, all relationships really should be loving, but I mean, like, we're very, I think I'm very like this, and he knows that I like him being like that, so he's kind of learned to, like, do it to me, for me too. But I'm always like, I love you so much, or like, you're so amazing because of this. Like, I'm very verbal and communicative, and like, what makes me happy. So I always say like, oh, you're so sexy, or I'm so lucky, or like, anything along those lines. And so we regularly, like, give each other almost positive affirmations, which I love. And then lastly, I'll say that our relationship is very sexy, but if I say more, then he'll probably get mad, so just use your imagination. Scarlett Petrucci asked, how do you stay fit? Much love. Thank you. I guess I wouldn't consider myself fit by any means. I get winded easily, but I guess the main reason why I'm not, like, overweight, I guess, I feel like I have a pretty normal body. I'm not super tiny. I don't think I could ever be super tiny. It's just not possible. But the main thing for me is diet. Like, I eat healthy. I eat salad. I eat oatmeal for breakfast or a smoothie. My, like, biggest treat on a regular week is banana ice cream. So I think that helps, or sushi, to be honest. I have a sushi addiction at the moment. But you get what I mean. I think diet is, like, the most important factor in staying fit. And then beyond that, I work out a few times a week, mostly kind of weights and, like, bum kind of exercises, which I talk more about in another video that might already be up. I'm sweating, by the way, you guys, because I can't have the AC on when I'm filming, and I'm just dying. So actually, I think I'm gonna end the video too, because I see my camera's about to die. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that you didn't mind that this was another kind of just chatty video of me. More roleplays to come, I swear. I love you guys very much. Thank you to everyone who did send questions. I really appreciate it. And I will see you guys again.